Hey there, HBI guys, Model Workshop here with taking a look at a ship kit. We haven't done a ship kit in a while, and I love boat kits. And I picked this one up recently. This is a re-release. This kit has been out for a very long time. It's been updated and changed and messed around with since then. But this is the North Sea Fishing Trawler by Revell Germany. It's 1/142nd scale. It is 37.3 centimeters long. I don't know the instant metric conversion, but that makes it about 14 inches long, we'll just roughly say, off the top of my head. So it is a nice size kit. The great thing about this kit, if you like ship kits, there isn't a lot of fishing boat kits out there. And this thing is alarmingly inexpensive. Probably because they've made so many of these that now it's just a license to print money whenever they re-release it. But this cost me $14.95 online, which nowadays for kit prices is completely acceptable. So let's take a look at everything that's in the box. The outside of the box has some awesome artwork, like Revell Germany always does in action. I do some little trivia about this kit while we're looking at the way it's going to look when it's assembled, is that for a while they used to release this kit as a spy ship back in the days when that was so cool. The James Bond, you know, when this came out and people always wanted stuff like that, they released this as like a spy ship, you know, that they were pretending to be a fishing trawler, but really they were using it to spy. And now, because that stuff isn't so popular anymore, they just released it as a North Sea fishing trawler, which is what, you know, which is what it can be, so that anyone that likes to build ships can have themselves a nice representation. Everything inside the box is exactly what you're going to expect. The Revell Germany manual is their standard style manual. It's a large book in black and white, almost like a newsprint style paper. It isn't the multi-part fold-out. They do give you a nice parts breakdown to make sure that you have all your stuff. Why some American companies don't do that, I don't know. Saves a lot of headaches if you're building the kit, find out you're missing one tiny part. Now, they do tell you to glue the hull in that, and I love this. You know, it says glue and then wait. Wait, wait, wait. Patience. It's a two-part hull with a one-piece deck, and if you don't glue that together properly and clamp it and wait, and you try to put the other parts on, it's just going to go all to holy hell. So I kind of love that clock on there. Wait and just let time pass and let that glue dry fully. You can see there's a good amount of steps, even though it isn't a giant, super detailed, super expensive kit. That's why I think it's such a wonderful deal. And you get to the back, and then you've got a wonderful paint guide letting you know to paint the water lines, where they should go, colors of your deck, your aft, your bow, your stern, your different decks on there, the masts and everything, and then of course you'll be able to rig the kit as well. And it's extremely simple rigging, as you can see. So if you've never rigged anything before, it's going to go like that. It's just snap fast. It's really easy to rig these. And then there's just some blank pages for notes. Also in the box is a very small sheet of decals. We'll get those nice and close. A lot of them are in white. You'll see the numbers going by. And those are self-explanatory. Also in the box is just a little spool of rigging. Nothing fancy there. Black thread. If you don't like the thread they used, go ahead and use your own. Little HPI guys tip here. Take your thread and put your thumb on it when you have a length you want to use, and just go get a candle from anywhere in the house. Any kind of candle, doesn't matter. Just take it and pull the thread over that candle, and just get a little bit of wax on there, and you'll find out the thread stays where you want it to stay. It's easier to tie, and it doesn't get all fuzzy-wuzzy-wuzzy. Here's some parts trees. This is all in white plastic, and I apologize in advance. Cameras have a hard time focusing in on just solid white plastic, because there really is nothing to focus in on. But these are much of the smaller parts of the ship, and I'm going to try to tilt it so you guys can see the portholes. Oh boy, see, here we go. The portholes, the ladders, all the stuff on there. Pretty good detail for a kit that's older than I am. This kit has to have been out for 40 years. The most recent date stamp on the mold is 1993. And I know it's been out before that because I found old versions of this online for sale. This is the exhaust tower. The main cabin area. See, the main cabin area is going to be in the front here. The bridge. Not the bridge of the Enterprise, but the bridge of the fishing trawler. You can see access hatches in the back here by my thumb. So it's nice detail. But anyways, yeah, like I was saying, the most recent incarnation of this kit's 1993 and then 2015, of course. But this goes back quite a long while. They just changed the dates. I guarantee when they upgraded the molds, did a little cleaning up or changing to them. This is your one of your upper decks. This is your second level deck. You can see where the cabins are going to go. And then you can see some non-slip surface detail on that plastic. And you can see some of the railings, a little bit of flash and stuff on them, but not bad. The railings are a little thick for the scale, but unless you want to go to Photo Etch and make your own, that's what you have. And they don't look bad at all. They honestly don't. They don't. I've seen pictures of the completed model on the box. The stock rails look fine. This is part of your stand. And there's your prop and your rudder. And then here's another. This is going to be your, what would they call that? Your bow deck. And you can see all the nice little holes in there pre-done for the railings that they have. The last individual parts tree, like I said, there's only a 3 to 4 parts trees in this whole thing. Is the large one-piece main deck, which is great. I do like that. And Mr. Camera is going to cooperate. You can see that wood grain in there. Give him a second to catch up. Nice wood grain. A little big for the scale. Cleats and tie-offs. Nice detail on that main deck. You can see everything's in 3D. And the smooth parts are, we're going to have other types of accessories mounted onto that deck, so there's absolutely no reason to have wood grain molded in it. So that's very nice looking. And then you've got, of course, your boat. And this thing next to here is actually the cover. So when it hangs off, it doesn't fill with water when it's hanging off the side of the boat. But you can see the detail on that little boat there. The planking, and then the actual cover does actually have texture to it. And we've got some railings, markers. We've got a winch right here that I'm tapping with my finger from underneath. The detail's kind of soft on that, but not bad. Anchor. Railings and railings and more railings, which actually look quite good if you take a look at them. I mean, they bend around corners and everything. And they're in actually pretty good shape. A little bit of flash, because I'm sure they have to turn the pressures up to inject this in there. And then there's some dudes. He got rain jackets on. He's like, "Oh, it's fishing out in the cold." I don't know if this one Gorton or is this one Gorton. Which one of them is the fisherman? Whichever one it is, you got to paint him yellow. And he's working hard to bring you your fish sticks. Yeah, you got some inflatable buoys. And I might be wrong. Those might not be buoys. Those might be inflatable lifeboats. But as old as this kit is, I'm guessing they're more buoys and markers than they are in the higher tech inflatable lifeboats. And there are a few things missing off the tree. They're in the bag. They're more of the buoys, more piece of railing and stuff like that. Then you've got your masts right here that all look well. So you've got that nice big tree there. That's a lot of your detail parts. And then the final tree in the kit is going to be the two-piece hull. And even though it is two-piece, it does have a nice keel on it, which will allow you to clamp it together. And there is some railing work on the hull tree. And you're going to want to cut the hulls free, because otherwise you're going to destroy those railings. But you can see the hull is in great shape. Both sides sit flat on the table. They're not warped. They're not jacked up. So Revell has been taking care of the mold. They're not letting it get all warped out and funky looking. Let's see if we can pick up the detail on that hull. Those lines not only are structural, but they'll help you paint your water lines too. Really easy to mask a hull like this. Give it a second here. There we go. And very nice lines to it, you know, with your rudder, your prop protection. Very well. And on the inside, you can see that they do have locator pins. They got the pins and the holes to put it together. Overall, very nice kit. I've never actually put this kit together before. I've never owned one before. I've seen it online. And even the old ones from back in the day go for not a lot of money. But the brand new one being only $14.95, if you like ship kits or if you want to give ship kits a try and you want to do just a little minimal rigging and just see how you can do with it, you know, you can end up with a really beautiful boat. So I definitely say it's worth the price of the kit, and I think you should go pick one up and give model boats a try. Thanks for watching.